for providing an intro of the e-health initiatives in the country. So we at the Department of Health, together with the partner agencies as mentioned by Dr. Sarmiento, together with UP Manila, DOST, DICT, and the PhilHealth, we've developed the Philippine eHealth Strategic Plan. So to give you a background for context setting, we developed the plan based on organizational goals that are aligned with national and international commitments. So we're aligned with the Philippine Development Plan. We're also aligned with the e-government master plan, which is being developed by the DICT. And this is our basis for the development of the health enterprise architecture. Of course, we also have the national objectives for health, and we also align with international commitments like the Sustainable Development Goals and commitments from the World Health Assembly. All of this to come up with our health enterprise architecture and the eHealth strategic plan. And for more detail, DOH Information System strategic plan. So here is the e-government master plan. If you're aware, we at the government agencies are aligned with this, wherein e-health is only one of the components. Okay? So we've mentioned that there will be a unified ID system wherein the citizen registry is the authoritative registry for the national ID. It's a collaboration, it's a group composed of the PSA, SSS, PhilHealth, and so on. We're also waiting for this national ID to be put in place so that we could also follow and be aligned with this. So with the Philippine Health Agenda, we have three guarantees, and we have the achieved strategy as mentioned by Dr. Raymond, wherein I is invest in e-health and data for decision making. This is under the Duterte administration, the Philippine Health Agenda. So again, specifically for invest in e-health and data for decision making, we're mandating the use of EMRs in health facilities. So we're providing policies to mandate the use of EMRs. In 2016, PhilHealth already issued a PhilHealth circular mandating the use of EMRs for the submission of the primary care benefit packages and also for submitting electronic claims. So our vision for 2020 is to have ICT-enabled health facilities in the country. So there is also a tall order with our previous secretary, Secretary Obiel, to have EMRs in place by 2018. So this is already started with the initial implementation of the PHI-ELI, wherein I'll give you a brief status later on. So here is the eHealth program components, wherein on top is the most important component, the governance. This is established, again, as I said earlier, with the partner agencies, composed of the secretaries of DOH, DICT, DOST, and the head of PhilHealth, and the chancellor of UP Manila. And then another important component is legislation, policy, and compliance, standards and interoperability, and in the middle is the eHealth solutions. Of course, we also have strategy and investment, infrastructure, and capability building. So that's why we partnered with DICT, because DOH is not expected to put up the infrastructure needed for eHealth. So with the word E, we need to have the right infrastructure in place. So we're partnering with DICT so that we will be connected nationwide up to the lowest level. So based on our previous steering committee meeting, we had status of connecting the RH, up to the RHU level and the DOH government hospitals. As of the moment, although not all, around I think 200 plus RHUs are already connected. So the strategic phases are as follows. For the eHealth strategic plan, the phase one is to standardize and connect, which is 2013 to 2014, and phase two is to transform, and phase three is to maintain and measure. So we've already established the governance and we've set standards by coming up with administrative orders to establish standards for data interoperability and several other major policies in place to implement the Philippine Health Information Exchange. And we're continuing the implementation of the Philippine Health Information Exchange, which is currently being implemented with the initial use case for the submission of the primary care benefit packages. Okay, I'll explain later on what the Philippine Health Information Exchange is all about. So currently, we're in the status of expanding its implementation and measuring its impact and how we can continuously improve the implementation of the PHIE. So what have we done so far when it comes to legislation, when it comes to governance? We've, as I said earlier, we've already established the e-health governance headed by the Secretary of Health. So right now, the current OIC for the health is Secretary Valle. He's also will be the one to chair the e-health governance. So we've established different experts group, among which is the privacy experts group, standards experts group, and we also have a multi-sector advisory group composed of representatives from the private sector and academe and other concerned associations. We've also, for legislation policy, we've also drafted the e-health bill and it was forwarded to Congress. And then we've also drafted several policies that are critical for the implementation of the e-health program. Sorry. So among which are the following major issuances. So even before the crafting of the IRR for the Data Privacy Act, we've already drafted, because DOH, the e-health program is very serious when it comes to health privacy. And we, part of the e-health governance, we're the one to propose the establishment of the National Privacy Commission. So we've, one of our consultants, we've also forwarded, I think, attorney knows. So we've already drafted the major policies in implementing PHIE, and currently we just finished the public hearing or public consultation for health privacy code for the different health facilities, both government and private, again in support to the implementation of the Data Privacy Act. So this is the Philippine Health Information Exchange. We have the point of care at the bottom, the hospitals, the health centers or clinics, and at the middle is the interoperability layer, and what Dr. Raymond explained earlier, we have the shared health record. I think some of the questions will be answered with this diagram. We're in the initial use case, but the shared health record will still need to be established. It's in a common database. Currently, PHIE Lite is being hosted in PhilHealth, but it's proposed to be hosted in the government cloud. That's why we're partnering with DICT. So again, we have the standards in place, the policies in place, we've implemented the PHIE Lite. The ultimate vision is to have the full shared health record, but we're going them towards that step by step, okay? So currently, since we have the standards in place, the different EMR developers used by the different rural health units are able to comply with the submission to PHIE Lite. That's why we have Cheats, Shine, EHATID, of course, Clinic Seas implemented, and they are able to submit to PHIE Lite. And we have harmonized DOH and PhilHealth analytics. So this is an ongoing, still to be presented to the DOH Execom. So currently, we have this scenario. Previously, we have separate portals or way of submission to DOH and PhilHealth. So our health workers are all clamoring that they're already overburdened with submitting almost the same data to two different agencies. So we've harmonized processes and way of submission in order that using an EMR, the health facility workers will be able to submit to both DOH and PhilHealth. So with the current use case with the PHI Lite, this is already in place. And our future implementation will be as follows. Wherein even our citizen, we can also view our own shared health record. The authorized healthcare providers will be able to view the shared health record also. And of course, all the relevant government agencies. So with that, just major challenges. We in